Wow, I have no clue what's going on, but I like it.
All right, back with another Eminem reaction. We're checking out Without Me. Let's get into it.
In 5, 4,
what?
3, 2, 1. Homie Trice, real name, no gimmicks.
Two trailer park girls go round the outside, round the outside, round the outside.
We've got a bogey. I'm on the way.
Two trailer park girls go round the outside, round the outside, round the outside.
Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend.
I'm so confused.
Okay, you ever heard this one?
No.
I've definitely heard this one.
Nah.
This was so popular back in the day.
What day?
Back in our day. We were young. I don't know. I would guess middle school, high school era. I don't know. I've totally heard this song, though. More than once.
Well, if you want shady, this is what I'll give you. A little bit of me mixed with some hard liquor, some vodka that'll jumpstart my heart quicker than a shock when I get shocked at the hospital by the doctor when I'm not cooperating, when I'm rocking the table while he's operating. Hey! You waited this long to stop debating, cause I'm back, I'm on the rag and ovulating. I know that you got a job, Miss Cheney, but your husband's heart problem's complicating. So the FCC won't let me be, or let me be me, so let me see. They try to shut me down on MTV, but it feels so empty without me. So come on and dip, bum on your lips, jump back, jiggle a hip and wiggle a bit, and get ready, cause this is about to get heavy. I just settled all my lawsuits. Fuck you, Devin! Now this looks like a job for me, so everybody just follow me, cause we need a little controversy, cause it feels so empty without me. I said,
what is he talking about?
I don't know. I have no clue.
A little controversy. He was talking about settling all his lawsuits.
Yeah, if you're talking about specifics, I don't know.
Yeah. I just love the old Eminem videos and like the sort of...
Yeah, that's super creative.
Like the sort of... Yeah.
When I was so young when I was listening to this, I wasn't keeping up with the lawsuits and all that kind of... The FCC must have been, I guess, trying to censor him or
this was
keep
probably
him off certain
when we
platforms.
Were in elementary school.
I don't know about that.
Probably.
Maybe. But,
I went to Catholic elementary school. I did not hear this.
I mean, I wasn't listening to it in school.
True. But like your friends.
So I used to buy CDs when I was a kid.
Yeah.
But I don't know, maybe watching MTV or something. I don't know, but this song was super popular back in the day.
Wow. I have no clue what's going on, but I like it.
Yeah, I mean, do you even need to know the specifics?
No.
I've never seen the music video.
Oh.
I've heard the song.
Because we need a little controversy, because it feels so empty without me. Little hellions, kids feeling rebellious, embarrassed, the parents still listen to Elvis. They start feeling like prisoners helpless, till someone comes along on a mission and yells, bitch! A visionary, vision is scary, can start a revolution, polluting the airwaves, a rebel. Notice, let me revel and bask in the fact that I got everyone kissing my ass, and it's a disaster, such a catastrophe, for you to see so damn much of my ass, you ask for me, well I'm back, fix your minutes and I'm tuning in and then I'm gonna enter in and up under your skin like a splinter. The center of attention, back for the winner, I'm interesting. The best things in wrestling, investing in your kids' ears and nesting. Testing, attention please. Feel attention, soon as someone mentions me. Here's my 10 cents, my 2 cents is free. A nuisance, who sent? You sent for me? Now this looks like a job for me. So everybody, just follow me. Cause we need a little controversy. Cause it feels so empty without me. I said this looks like a job for me.
What?
They were like pretend, like you know, the old school sort of like pretending the car's moving. They're probably on green screen, so they're like. They seem like real friends, like real life friends.
Oh, I think they are.
Wow, and he helps him out, right? Like Dre helped Eminem.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. I wonder if they're still like close like this.
From reading the comment section, I think they are. I don't know. I haven't looked it up. Yeah. But people in the comments are saying they're still best friends. Remember, you were asking if they were beefing or something.
Yeah.
Because remember, it was like the Dr. Dre's missing on the milk carton or whatever, and you were asking if they're beefing in the comments. I said, no, they're good friends.
Wow. That's cool. They look like they're having fun.
Because we need a little controversy, because it feels so empty without me. I'm still gonna task it. I go tit for tat with anybody who's talking this and that shit. Chris Kirkpatrick, you can get your ass kicked. Worse than the Middle Limp Bizkit bastards. And Moby, you can get stomped by Obi. You 36-year-old boy-headed stare. You don't know me, you're too old. Let go, it's over. Nobody listen to techno, now let's go. Just give me the signal, I'll be there with a whole list full of new insults. I've been no suspenseful with a pencil ever since Prince turned himself into a symbol. But sometimes, man, it just seems everybody only wants to disgust me. So this must mean I'm disgusting. But it's just me, I'm just obscene. Yeah. Though I'm not the first king of controversy, I am the worst thing since Elvis Presley. To do black music so selfishly and use it to get myself wealthy. Hey, that's a concept at worst. 20 million other white rappers emerge. But no matter how many fish in the sea, it'll be so empty without me. Now this looks like a top of me. So everybody just follow me.
Such a good job at like taking the criticism and the controversy and the negativity people are giving him and like making it funny.
Right.
I feel like almost every old school song we've listened to like that is about somebody like has a problem with him or blames him for everything or, you know.
Yeah, a lot of them, but then he has songs about his mom.
True.
He writes about a ton of stuff. Maybe those are the ones that stick out to you the most.
Yeah, this is a very nostalgic style of video. Like the sound, the look, like the way they filmed it, like the angles and stuff, and just like the, it's almost like a caricature of real life, you know? Like it's not quite cartoony, but it's not quite like reality TV, you know what I mean? It's like somewhere in the middle. And even the beats are kind of like a little bit more wonky than like a standard hip hop
beat. I mean, it's way different than today's beats for sure.
Yeah. Super, I mean, it's just, yeah.
I just can't believe you've never heard the song.
Right?
What?
But also, you know me. Can you really?
No. I mean, you used to listen to MTV, right?
No.
Never?
No.
Are you serious?
I didn't know what TRL was. Like, no. I used to watch VH1 sometimes, but I did not watch MTV.
Dang.
And I only watched VH1 in like ninth grade when I would be in the basement late at night and my parents didn't know I was down there.
Oh, they wouldn't let you watch.
No.
Oh.
I didn't watch BET either. I literally did not watch BET till college when my roommate watched BET.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
And even then you were watching like shows, like some show?
She used to watch The Game in college and I watched that with her. But I didn't watch BET before that, like. Yeah, so it's like, yeah, this culture is so like foreign to me, but.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.